Well, how's everybody today? Welcome to the Kerrigan Yes, we got a caller right now. Yes, welcome to the Kerrigan Talk Show, the Kerrigan Hour. Today we're rolling up on the 12th of January. Got a big show for all the bikers and car enthusiasts coming out to the Cow Palace. That's a big scene, people from all over. Gonna be in the Bay Area. And we'll see a lot of friends, see a lot of real nice cars, and should be a real good event. The events of this new year are getting pretty interesting. We've got a combination of events with a lot of different people. We got Bush. I don't know what he's doing. I don't even think he knows what he's doing. But somehow I feel, well, there's a connection between Bush and we call it vertical arabesque. It's going off to the side and getting a different perspective. That is the Trump Rosie O'Donnell show. They're headline grabbers. These are things that the society at large should pay close attention to, how the media and powers that be can manipulate a political situation. We have also Mr. Schwarzenegger, who is a friend, and I voted for him, lots of confidence. He's selling now a proposal for the infrastructure that quietly veiled as a tax is now going through for a large chunk of California taxpayers' money, but it's not going to be called a tax. It's going to be called a fee. That's for those who study political science. And there's ways that people pay for things inadvertently through a different name. Main thing we're concerned with is the war in Iraq, and now brewing up Somalia. These are very serious times. We don't know what will be coming around the corner next, because there is a, I think, an administration out of control. We have too many situations that are beyond the average American and the families of the United States comprehension and or control. We have Condoleezza Rice now, once a respected Secretary of State, getting down in the dirt with whoever's, you know, signing your paycheck, so to speak. You have to ask why about 20 people who had formerly been appointed by Mr. Bush, they leave, they come, they go. I mean, this is something, this is a power that is unbelievable. How one person can take us into a situation like this, escalated with public opinion, with just about everybody against it, and he's the only one that seems to feel that he knows what time it is. This is something that is going to very, very, very come down to a bad situation. I'm at a loss for words because, you know, I spent time in school, but these things now, it's getting too much. It's like you take the computers that are easy to understand if you educate yourself to the ways they work, but you take the same thing supercharged by a government and their supercomputers, and you have no instruction book on how things are coming about. You don't have a manual, so to speak, to look at, a playbook, and we'll see how things happen. But I definitely feel, with all good intentions, that we need more support from other countries and other people to continue this situation we have going. The Iraqi people, along with many other citizens throughout the world, have their trials and tribulations. At any given time, there may be 30 wars going on without the world. That given your idle thoughts, I don't subscribe to any war one way or another, but there was a question of motivation. Is it oil? Is it something to do with a vendetta against Saddam Hussein that brought this whole thing into a one man against another man? Now it's going out of control with billions of dollars and thousands of people dying. I just don't know. So we're going to go into a commercial, and the second part of the show we'll take questions. And I really appreciate everybody watching the show tonight. So hold on one second, and we'll be right back. Thank you very much. This is